Hey, what's up, everybody? Ballet at Bran, the Sci-Viving Hexakin. And in this second video, what I want to be stressing and emphasizing is who you surround yourself with and who is in your inner circle is extremely important to either your successes or your failures. Now, here's what I mean. So say if the four people or the five best friends you have, say if they're all homeless and you're the one that's not homeless. Well, as far as equilibrium goes and as far as spending your time with people in that nature, most likely you're going to be developing habits that they did, whether positive and negative, that got them to their place in the first place, right? So maybe you weren't homeless in the first place, but now you become that way because you've surrounded yourself with that environment. And it's just the exact opposite as well, right? If you are in a positive environment, a uplifting, encouraging, energetic, wealthy environment, and have those kinds of people in your friend circle, well, then instead of telling someone your idea, your ambitions, your dreams, and having them shut you down, well, now if you're around successful people and people that love you, then now they say, oh, you know what, Brandon? Yeah, you can totally achieve that, or whatever the person's name is. Instead of those limiting, fearful beliefs, now it's like the abundance mentality. And the abundance mentality really is coming from a mindset of abundance, as opposed to scarcity and what happens if I fail, or, if I don't succeed, things like this. And the reason why I say this is so important is because for me, the Hex community has been super beneficial and very uplifting of a community for me to be in and participate in. But I've also been in the opposite, as I mentioned, where I've been in some environments where, the energy was not positive for my success. It was not encouraging for me to want the ambitions and to achieve the ambitions. And so even if these people are your family, your friends, your loved ones, you really need to consider what you give your time to and your energy to, because once again, even if you don't believe someone with their limiting belief that they have against you, right, against one of your dreams, well, even if you don't believe them, just the thought of being around someone in general that has those negative doubts towards you, and some of them subconsciously or even consciously want you to fail because they don't want to see you succeed. Maybe they're not doing anything themselves and they see you being ambitious and wanting success as a threat, right, to their current paradigm. So when I retired from my job, Mutual Materials in Bellevue, when I had gotten the job, maybe when I turned 20 or 21, and this is very on topic to what I'm talking about, but in the interview is myself and three of the senior executive managers. And one of them said, where do you see yourself in 5 years? And I had just gotten into crypto maybe two and a half years before that. And I had told him, I said, honestly, with this crypto thing and this technology, I see myself being retired. And, one of them kind of just looked at me, with the blank stare, and the other one kind of chuckled, and the other one was sowing doubt, saying that, like, oh yeah, that crypto stuff is just, all bubbles. And so the point that I'm getting at is, even though I worked for Mutual Materials, even though I had employees and customers that I was helping on a daily basis, I still chose who I spent my time with and where I spent a majority of my time around. Most people, even myself included before I retired, but you're spending more time at your job generally than you are with your family or with your loved ones. So what you really do focus on and pay attention to can make all the difference in the world. The same job that I had, there was a coworker that I was working with alongside this trailer where we'd help all the contractors. And people would ask me, like, oh, what's that thing on the wall? And it was a whole bunch of Hex and a whole bunch of, like, successful photos. And I would say, hey, it's just crypto. And the other coworker that was clearly depressed, clearly sowing doubt, he was older too, so he's not happy for an ambitious young guy like me to be, you know, ecstatic. But he would always say like, oh yeah, you know, Brandon's in crypto, you know, and all of this stuff, kind of pushing it off and pretending like my dreams and things that I had wanted to see successful, like they weren't going to happen. And so I limited myself around that person and even people as well, like I said, in my family. And obviously not naming any names specifically, that's never appropriate, but I had had times in Hex where when I first got into it, I didn't tell a single person. I was already in crypto before then and decided to get into Hex because of all of the legitimacies that it has. But then when I had started telling, you know, certain people that were close to me or certain, you know, members, they had immediately sowed doubt and immediately tried to talk me away from continuing, you know, my goals in the community and Richard Hart. And lo and behold, the same person that had, you know, tried to sow those seeds of doubt, they had also not done very well when it comes to their intentions with Hex, right? They sold it 20% of a penny when we had like an 86% dump on Big Payday, and I was still holding. And the point that I'm getting at is, you know, if you have the ambition and the will to succeed, then, you know, you'll be able to do it. You'll be able to find a way. But it really comes with limiting the amount of time that you spend with for people that are negative and people that don't want you to succeed. And then maximizing the amount of time with yourself, focusing on things that you can control. I'll wrap this up very soon here, but I've got a screen share that I want to cover. So this goes to someone like myself, right? I didn't have a whole bunch of friends, to be honest. Growing up in high school, I was always very introverted. I took Running Start so I could avoid the high school experience and to meet more mature people in college. But the point that I'm getting at is, say if you're like me, an introvert, and you're saying, Bran, you know, I know that you say that you're the average of the five or the four people that you hang around with most, but I don't even have that, you know, like me. And I don't even have any friends like I did, which is fine. The cool thing about the technology that we have today and just the opportunities is with the internet, like you can meet anyone around the world. And in the Hex.com community, I've had the chance to have business opportunities, friendships, you know, amazing things happen that normally would have never happened. I promise you, they never would have happened in the real world. So use this technology for good and for benefiting yourself and other people, as opposed to, you know, using it for a detriment and some of the bad things that can come with, say, social media. You look at, let me zoom in here on the screen. So this right here, this is the founder of Hex, Richard Hart, the guy to the left of him, Funding Jim, absolutely amazing person. Honestly, I can't even go over all of the names here because there's just too many good stories to tell. But for someone like myself that didn't really fit in a lot of these other groups, right? I've never been a fan of sports, never been a fan of movies and some of these other things, right? So I never kind of really fit in with the narrative or what other people were doing. And so instead, I had spent that time, researching and acquiring knowledge about things that I could control and things that I was interested in. And lo and behold, it turns out I found Richard Hart. I found the best community that I've ever been a part of. And then the last thing I'll say too is, when you are successful, and especially with this abundance mentality, but when you are successful and the people around you, they're prospering, they're successful, well, they see your success and they want to celebrate it as if it was theirs as well. You know, you don't see that success as a scarcity mindset or as a thing to be fearful of. You say, no, this person around me who's in my core is succeeding, and you know, you obviously help contribute to that success, whether people realize it or not. But the amazing thing is You can constantly be celebrating other people's success and vice versa. They can do the same thing for you. And it really is just like a back and forth, like a game of ping pong, where people can really help other people grow and escape, you know, poverty or depression and things like this when you put in the effort and when you, you know, allow yourself to have these kinds of opportunities. Once again, nothing just completely falls on your lap. But if you understand that if there are negative influences and, you know, negative Neelys and Nancys around your life, if you understand that that is really cancerous to any form of success, then you can slowly, you know, no one has all of the control in the world and everyone's situation is a little bit different. But if you understand that, you can slowly start to find, you know, different times and different behaviors to get yourself away from those cancerous people. Because if there's one thing that I know, once again, it is toxic people that misery does love company, right? And they want to be around people that are negative and that are not succeeding. And if they have someone in their life, like my coworker, right? And like all the people that ever sowed doubt to me, they don't want to see your success and they see it as a threat. So if you can avoid those people and get rid of those people, even if they're your family, loved ones, whatever, if you can get rid of them at all costs, in my opinion, that's the most important thing you can do, because you really are a product of your environment. And if you want to succeed, you got to start having an environment that allows you to be successful, as opposed to one that's constantly sowing doubt and negative. So I hope this was helpful. Once again, this is not focused on crypto. This is just on self-help, things that I've learned, you know, more personal stories on this type of channel. But if you are looking for a good community, there's a Telegram, so t.me/SCIVIVE or t.me/HEXCrypto, CRYPTO. And the reason that I say that is because it was a community that I had found and that I had been an early member and part of that, you know, wasn't just focused on crypto or wasn't just focused on surviving through science and longevity, but it turned out to be a lot more. And so many more opportunities opened themselves to me once I had put my foot in the door and once I had taken that initiative. So really hope this was helpful for anyone. If anyone does have any like questions or concerns or topics that you want me to cover, please do reach out in the comments. And I'll do my best to make it a topic, make it something that I do talk about, because this channel is for everyone, obviously for myself too, but there's so much that I want to cover. And I know yesterday was just the first of my videos, but there's a whole lot to it, right? To be successful, whether it's financially, whether it's spiritually, you know, all of these different things, physically, mentally, you know, to be that way, you need to practice consistency. Nothing, once again, nothing that's worth doing comes overnight. So whether it's, you know, reading, whether it's a skill set or lifting weights and getting healthy, it all comes from being consistent and practicing those good habits and those good behaviors. So just as you can develop good habits, you can also unlearn things, right? You can unlearn some of those bad habits or some of those things that were just not useful to you at all. So I suggest people, you know, write down what's going on in your life, right? Write down the pros and the cons and the amount of people that you see and how much time you spend with them and kind of the after effect that you get with those people. Because you might just find that you've wanted to achieve some sort of success and then maybe you find that there's, you know, one cancerous person in your life that is kind of maybe preventing you from having that door open for the right person and for the right opportunity for that success. So write your goals down. Once again, I'll be producing more consistent videos, but it's not going to be just because it's going to be for things that I'm passionate about. So please let me know how I can help And I'll see everyone on the next video, okay? Allmylinks.com/Bally8Brand is where you can find all my other information. Thank you.